At the end of this video, you should be able to crash a given network problem and find out the optimum project time and optimum project cost for a given problem. Here is our problem statement. The following table gives the data on normal time and cost and crash time and cost for a project. Here is one project which is having these activities. Also, indirect costs are given as rupees 6. We have been given the activities of a project, normal duration of the project, crash duration of each activity, normal cost of each activity, and crash cost of each activity. Normal time is the time when everything is normal, what time it takes to complete one activity. Now, if you wish that by providing certain additional cost, you want to accelerate the given activity. So for this example, this activity 1-2 normally takes 9 days. But if you are ready to pay extra, it can be completed by 6 days. The normal cost associated with this activity 1-2 is 640 rupees. But if you wish to complete that activity within 6 days instead of 9 days, you have to pay the 700 rupees. So this is the meaning of this complete table. We have been asked to draw the network diagram for this project and for these activities, find the critical path and crash the relevant activities systematically and determine the optimum project time and cost. The first step is to get the network diagram, and let us see the network diagram that I have prepared for this problem. Here is an activity 1-2. So this particular activity 1-2 is represented over here. This activity 1-3 is represented over here. Activity 1-4 is represented over here. And this is the activity 2-4, right? So this is the activity 2-4. This is the activity 3-4 and 4-5. Now please note that the figure outside this bracket represents the normal time, and the figure in bracket represents the crash time. Once we are ready with the network diagram, the first step is to evaluate the cost slope for each activity. Now, what is a cost slope? Cost slope is nothing but how much cost it will take for an activity if you want to reduce this activity by only 1 day. So that is given by crash cost of a corresponding activity minus normal cost divided by normal time minus crash time. So let us calculate this crash time for one of the activities, and similarly you can calculate it for the remaining things. So let us calculate the crash cost for this activity 1-2. So the crash cost is given as 700 rupees minus normal cost is given as 640 rupees divided by normal time is given as 9 days and crash time is given as 6 days. So this will reduce to 20. We have represented this cost over here. Similarly, I have calculated the crash cost slope for each of these activities. Now this is essential to select the activity for crashing. So we will be selecting the activity which having least cost slope for crashing first. Also, please note that the total normal cost for this complete project is given by 1940. The next step is to calculate the critical path. How do we calculate the critical path? Now, the most simple method is given over here. Now, identify how many paths are there for this network diagram so that we can start from the event number 1 and we can go to the last event, that is event number 5. If I start from this one, if I go to 2, 4 and 5, that will be the one path. So let me write that path over here. And the normal time is given by 9 plus 5 plus 2. So that will be equal to 16. And if you calculate the crash time, 6 plus 3 plus 1, so that will be equal to 10. Second path will be 1, 4, 5. So I am writing here 1, 4 and 5, and normal time duration will be the 17, and the crash time duration will be the 11, and lastly 1, 3, 4, 5. So here is an 1, 3, 4, 5. The total duration will be 20 and crash time will be 12. Now here we can very easily point out that this 1, 3, 4, 5, that is 1, 3, 4, 5, is our critical activity, as it is taking the maximum time. Also, one more thing is that this particular activity can be crashed up to 12. Now remember that if you want to reduce the duration of this project, so what is meant by crashing? You, by paying some extra amount, you are ready to reduce the duration of this particular project. While crashing, we have to select those activities which are present on the critical path. So we have to consider the critical path, that is 1, 3, 4, 5 for crashing. Now let us select this critical path and let us see which activity we can crash. So if we select this 1, 3, 4, 5 as our critical path, so I will write down here 1, 3, 4, 5 as our critical path, and now I want to see which activity I can crash. So if I crash any of the activity on this critical path, it will reduce the duration of project by 1 day. Now this particular activity from path R 1, 3, 3, 4, and 4, 5, normal time associated with these activities can be figured out from this table. So the normal activities for this particular 1, 3 is 8. Now this data is available in the table. So also the crash time is also available in the table, and cost slope we have estimated. We have estimated this 1, 3, 4, 5 as a critical path. Also we have completed this table. Now it is time to get the information about the table, which is the most important. As we go on crashing the network, we have to fill this table and evaluate the total cost. So this table contains the number of days column, then a normal cost, crash cost, direct cost, which is the summation of this normal cost plus crash cost. There will be an indirect cost. So indirect cost for 1 day is given as 60 rupees. So we have to estimate the indirect cost for the given project duration, and this is the total cost. So total cost is nothing but this direct cost plus indirect cost. Let us fill this table for the starting values. Now we have to fill this table only for the critical path. So number of days on critical path are 20. So this is the total project duration right now. Normal cost is given by 1940. So this normal cost is nothing but the summation of normal cost of all the activities. And the crash cost, we are right now, we are not crashing, we are using a complete 20 days over here, so there will not be a crashing, so it will be a nil. So direct cost will be 1940 only. Now indirect cost, it is given that per day it takes 60 rupees, and we have a total project duration of 20 days. So 20 into 60 will give me a 1200 value, and this total cost will be summation of this DC plus IC, so which gives me a value of 3140. If you look closely at this table, it says that for this critical path the normal time is 20 days and crash time is 12 days, so meaning that the total project duration can be crashed up to 12 days. I have represented in this table all the values from 20 to 12 in descending order. Also the associated cost, normal cost, I have represented over here. It will be the same for whatever duration, it will not change. Crash cost, we have to estimate for this blank space. Also we need to estimate the direct cost, But the indirect cost we can estimate at this point for this 20 days, we seen that the indirect cost come to be 1200. Similarly, for 19 days, it will be 19 into 60 is equal to 1140. Now you can note that as the project duration is reducing, the indirect cost is also reducing, but this crash cost will increase, that we see later. It is essential to start crashing at this point. Now we want to crash the network from this 20 days to 19 days, and we need to crash any one of the activity on the critical path. So our critical path is 1345. So if you want to look this critical path over here, so this is 1345. I want to now crash one activity from this critical path. So I have three activities on critical path, 1334 and 45, and the cost slopes are 25, 15 and 40. Now I will select that activity for crashing, which is having the least cost slope. By paying this 15 rupees extra, I will reduce my duration of project by 1 day. So let us crash this activity on the network so that we have a record of that. Crash this activity 34 from 10 days to 9 days. I have to pay 15 rupees extra as a crash cost. So I will write down these values over here. So the crash cost will be 15 rupees, and for that my direct cost will increase to 1955, and this particular indirect cost, if I add to that, it will give me a value of 3095. You can note here that though I have crashed the activity by 1 day from 20 days to 19 days by paying the extra 15 rupees, still my total cost has reduced as the indirect cost is decreased. Now I wish to again crash this network from 19 days to 18 days, but before that we need to evaluate the critical path, whether the critical path is same or not. So I will just go to the network diagram and see what is the critical path still. So this, there is no change in this 1245, there is no change in this 145, but there is a change in 1345, and which is giving me a critical path of 19 days. So still my 1345 is the critical path, and I have again the same set of activities over here, and I can, though this activity is reduced to 9, I can still crash this activity 34, right? So I will crash this 34 activity one more time. So if I crash this 34 activity one more time, I have to pay the 15 rupees as a crash price. Okay, so now also remember that once we want to reduce this duration from 19 days to 18 days, this crash cost we have to carry forward. So 15, which is the this cost plus current 15 cost, will add to the total crash cost of rupees 30, and that will give me a direct cost of 1970, and that will also give me the complete total cost of 3050. Now you can say that still it is reducing, right? Now let us mark this crashing at this point. Now we have seen that here we have to make it 8, right? And also we have to make 8 at this point, right? And still this particular critical path has not changed till this point, right? And I have a same critical path as 1345, and I will be interested in crashing any one of these activities. So I will again crash this 34 activity only because it is having the least cost slope. So I need to add this 15 as a crash cost if I wish to go from 18 days to 17 days. So this 30 will be carry forward from the last iteration, 15 will be the new crash cost, that will give me a total crash cost of 45, and it will go to 1985, and total cost will be 3005. Right, now you can see that again this total cost is still reducing. Now let us try and mark this critical this crashing at this point. Now we have reduced this activity up to the 7 days. Let us try to evaluate the critical path. Now we have 3 paths, 1, 2, 4, 5. There is no change in the time of 1, 2, 4, 5. There is again no change in time of 1, 4, 5. It will be 17 only, but this path 1, 3, 4, 5 will have a duration of 8 plus 7 plus 2, that is 17. So I can write over here as 17. Now you can note that we have 2 critical paths. So 1, 4, 5, that is 1, 4, 5 is one critical path, and 1, 3, 4, 5 is other critical path. So what is the meaning of this? That if we want to reduce the duration of project, complete project, we have to crash the activity on both the paths. So that is 1, 4, 5 and 1, 3, 4, 5, as both are critical path. So we will formulate the same table for both the path. So we have this table for this 1, 3, 4, 5. Let us prepare this table for this critical path. Critical path 1, 4, 5. Okay. So how many activities are there? There are 2 activities. So activity 1, 4 and activity 4, 5. So what is the normal time of this 1, 4 activity? So normal time of this 1, 4 activity is 15, and I can crash it up to 10 days, right? And the cost of or cost slope is 30. Similarly, for this 4, 5, I have a normal time of 2 days, crash time of 1 day, and I can say that the cost slope is 40. So similar data over here. So activity 1, 3 is having a normal time of 8 days and crash time of 5 days, and it is having the cost slope of 25. Similarly, 3, 4. Now actually this activity 3, 4 is having 7 days only, because we have crashed it up to the 7 days. And we can crash it up to 6 days, right? And it is having the cost slope of 15 days. Now this activity 4, 5 is common to both the critical path, right? So you can say that this activity 4, 5, it belongs to the both the path. So it belongs to 1, 4, 5, and it also belongs to 1, 3, 4, and 5, right? So with this, now we have to decide how much, which quantities are to be now crashed, which activities are to be now crashed, so that we can reduce the duration of this project from 17 days to 16 days. Now, as usual, let us try to consider the activity over here with the least cost slope. So if I select, let us say this 3, 4, right, and from here if I select this 1, 4, right? Okay, so that will give me a, because we have to consider, we have to crash both activities, one activity from this path and one activity from this path. So this total will be 30 plus 15 will give me value of 45, right? But I have a more better option. Now this particular activity 4, 5 is common to both. So if I crash it once, right, if I crash this activity 4, 5 once, that will reduce the duration of both the path, right? So, and it is having only 40 cores. Here we have 30 plus 15. So if I want to crash this 1-4 and 3-4, I will have to pay how many rupees? 30 plus 15, 45 rupees. So instead of that, I will crash this activity 4-5. So let us crash this activity 4-5. So if I crash this 4-5, so I will register the changes in this table, right? So we have this table. This 45 will come, right, as a cumulative cost, right? So this 45, and we are crashing which activity? We are crashing this activity 4-5. So this, the cost is 40. So it will give me a cost of 85, right? And the direct cost will be this 1940 plus 85. That will give me a cost of 2025. And it will add this cost, and total cost will be given by 2985. Now you can notice that the total cost is still reducing. Okay, now one thing is to be noted over here is that now this particular activity we have crashed, right? Okay, and sorry. Yeah, so we have crashed it to one day, right? So now I cannot further crash it, right? Because what is happening over here? This normal time is equal to the crash time. So I will mark hashes over here, right? So that this activity, we cannot further cross it or crash it, right? So what I will do again, I will mark it with red pen cross, because further this activity will not be crashed. Now let us try to find out the duration of each path. So this 1, 2, 4, 5 path will have 9 + 5 + 1, that is 15 days of an duration. 1, 4, 5 will have 15 + 1, that is 16 number of days as duration, and this 1, 3, 4, 5 will have 8 + 7, 15 + 1, 16 number of days as a duration. Now we are again getting two critical paths. So 1, 4, 5 and 1, 3, 4, 5, two critical path we are getting. So I will mark them as critical path, and we have the same tables one more time. Now only thing is that now I cannot reduce this activity 4-5 further, because it has exhausted, it has come to its limit, right? Now we have to reduce, we have to select one activity from this path. So we don't have a choice but to select this 1-4 activity. So we will select 1-4 from this path, right? And it is having a cost slope of 30, and from this particular table we will select the activity which is having the least cost slope. So we will select the 3-4, right? We can still further reduce this activity by one day. So if I select this 3-4 from here, right, so this will give me cost slope of 15 days, right? So total cost will be 30 + 15, right? So that is equal to 45. So this is the total cost required to reduce the project duration from 16 days to 15 days, right? So let us mark these things in this table. So I will be writing here. So this 85 is the cost which we are taking from this upper row, plus 45 is the current crashing cost, and that will give me a value of 130. This will become 2070, and final cost will become 2970. Now we further we want to reduce this duration from 15 days to 14 days. But before that, let us mark these things over here. The 7 will be reduced to now 6, right? And as this 6 is equal to the crashing, right? So I cannot further crash this activity now. So 3, 4, I will mark it as a hashed, indicating that now this activity will not be crashed more. So we have also reduced this 1-4 activity from 15 days to 14 days. If we again reevaluate the critical paths, so 1, 2, 4, 5 will have a project duration of or part duration of 15 days. This 1, 4, 5 will have again a duration of 15 days, and this 1, 3, 4, 5 will also have a duration of 15 days. Now, interestingly, all the three paths have become the critical path. So, meaning is that we have to crash all the activities, so one activity from each path, so as to reduce the project duration from the 15 days to 14 days. Right. Okay. Now let us try to evaluate that. Now we had this table for this critical path 1, 3, 4, 5, this table for 1, 4, 5, and we have this additional table for 1, 2, 4, 5. Okay, and I have marked the activities which cannot be further crashed. So, from this critical path, we don't have a choice but to select the one activity, and we will select the activity which is having the low critical cost slope. Okay, so from this path, I will select this activity 2, 4, right, and which is having the cost of 10. From this table, I don't have much of the choice, but I will crash the activity 1, 4, and which is having the cost slope of 30. And again, from this table 1, 3, 4, 5, I can crash only one activity, that is activity 1, 3, and that is having the cost slope of 25. So if I add all these, so 10 plus 30 plus 25, that will give me a cost slope of 65, meaning that I have to pay 65 rupees more so that I can reduce the project duration from 15 to 14 days. So this 130, let me change the pen. So this 130 will be remain as it is, 65 will be the new cost, and that will reduce, that will go to 195. This total will become 2135, and it will be 2975. Now you can note one interesting thing over here. From this 20, as we reduce the duration from 20 to 19 to 18 to 17, 16 and 15, the project total project cost was reducing till this point, and at this point it is increased. So this point is often very much significant, that we will see later. But for now, we want to further reduce the project duration from 14 days to 13 days. Again, critical paths will be for 1, 2, 4, 5, it will be of 14 days. For 1, 4, 5, it will be of 14 days and 1345 it will be of 14 days. Now you have to note that I have already updated the activities which we have crashed already, right? Now again, as you can see that we have three critical paths. So we have 1245 as one critical path, 1-4-5 as second critical path, and 1-3-4-5 as third critical path. So we have to consider all these three paths for the crashing. Again, as we have seen in the last step, we will select this 2-4 for crashing from this 1-2-4-5, 1-4-4 from this path 1-4-5, and this activity 1-3 from 1-3-4-5. So total cost of crashing will be 10 plus 30 plus 25 equal to 65. Now I will record these activities in this table. So we are now crashing the network from 14 days to 13 days. So this 195 will be coming from the earlier row. Here I will be adding 65 to this values, and that will give me the value of 260, and it will go to 2200, and the total cost will be 2980. Also, we will update these activities on our network. So we have crashed this activity 1-3, and it will be reduced to 6 days. Also, we have crashed this activity 2-4, that will be reduced to 3 days, and this particular activity will reduce to 12 days. As you can note that the normal duration has reached to the crashing duration, so I will not be able to further reduce this activity or crash this activity, so I will make it hashed. Now we wish to further reduce this project duration from 13 days to 12 days. If we look at the path duration, so 1-2-4-5 will have a duration of 13 days. So let me mark it over here. So this 1-4-5 will have a duration of again 13 days, and this 1-3-4-5 will also have a duration of 13 days. Now again, as usual, all these three paths have become the critical path. So I need to reduce one activity from each of these paths so that I can reduce the project duration from 12 days to 13 days. Now from this critical path 1-2-4-5, I need to reduce the activity 1-2, as other two activities are reached to its limits. And from this 1-4-5, I will reduce this activity 1-4, and from this critical part 1-3-4-5, I will select this activity 1-3. So the total crash cost will be 20 plus 30 plus 25 equal to 75, and I will record these things in this table. This 260 will come from the last row. This 75 will come from existing crashing, and it will total value will be equal to 335 and 2275, and the total cost will be 2995. If I mark all these reduced activities to this network, we can see that now this network cannot be further crashed or duration cannot be further reduced. So it can be reduced till this 12 days. But if you take account at this total cost is decreasing till this point. So that is till 15 days, right? So at this point, this is the minimum value of this total cost. So we can say that it is feasible or it is okay to reduce the project duration from 20 days to 15 days, right? By paying the crash cost, that will actually benefit us in the total cost. If you reduce the project duration further, you may have to pay extra cost. So we can say that the optimum project duration is 15 days and the minimum cost of project will be 2970. So this is how we can compute the crashing of network. Thank you.